también un compromiso venir a la sede en donde los estados parte de esta convención se reúnen, más aún que han terminado ya la primera ronda de evaluación de la implementación de tan importante convención, conocida como la Convención de Mérida, que tiene la misma edad que GOPAC. La Organización Mundial de Parlamentarios contra la Corrupción tuvo en esa convención una inspiración de reconocer el papel que deben jugar los parlamentos, los congresos, los poderes legislativos en los estados para hacer avanzar no solo los compromisos de la convención, sino su espíritu, su verdadero propósito. Hoy por la mañana tuve la honrosa oportunidad de hablar en la plenaria frente a los delegados de todos los países a nombre de nuestra organización, de GOPAC. Y decía que para nosotros es absolutamente significativo el que se escuche la voz también, el pensamiento, la reflexión y las propuestas que desde la visión legislativa, que desde la función del Parlamento, que desde la responsabilidad de los representantes populares pueda vertirse en relación a la implementación y al avance de la convención, pero con resultados tangibles, con elementos concretos de comprobación de que de veras se lucha contra este flagelo. Decíamos en la mañana que estamos seguros que en todas las latitudes del planeta están ahora parlamentarias y parlamentarios estudiando, conociendo, reflexionando y debatiendo documentos generados por GOPAC en asociación, en alianza con otras organizaciones, con la propia sociedad civil, con la experiencia de quienes han estado en los congresos, en los parlamentos y ahora quieren seguir haciendo su aportación a través de nuestra organización, pero fundamental y centralmente de quienes hoy se encuentran en el centro del proceso de fiscalización, de la supervisión, de la representación que tienen los parlamentarios, las y los parlamentarios. Muchas gracias por estar aquí. Tendremos en esta tarde dos mesas de reflexión y de trabajo. Decíamos que estaban leyendo y discutiendo documentos emanados del trabajo de GOPAC y hoy se presentarán nuevos documentos, nuevas propuestas que no son concluyentes porque siempre en el Parlamento el debate, la reflexión y finalmente el contraste de las ideas se traduce en las decisiones que van orientadas a generar bienes públicos. Muchas gracias, bienvenidos. Si de esta tarde de reflexión una palabra, una idea sirve para que mañana se haya avanzado siquiera un metro en el camino de erradicar la impunidad y la corrupción, Si alguien a partir de estas reflexiones encuentra la manera de servirle bien, mejor a su país desde su función parlamentaria, nos sentiremos sumamente satisfechos. Basta con que la reflexión sea honesta, sea franca, que tengamos altura de miras, rectitud de intención y por sobre cualquier consideración parcial, regional, ideológica, partidaria, pongamos por encima el interés que nos une, hacer nuestras aportaciones para un mundo más justo, en donde la dignidad de la persona y sus derechos fundamentales no sean violentados por quienes, sin escrúpulos, se quedan con bienes que no les pertenecen, y eso es, a final de cuentas, la corrupción. Y su combate es la que nos une. Buenas tardes, bienvenidos. Este primer panel lo va a coordinar alguien a quien personalmente le tengo un respeto, una admiración y más cariño, que es la secretaria del Comité Global, del Comité Mundial de GOPAC, mi muy querida amiga Mary King, a quien después de haberles dado la bienvenida, desearles lo mejor a todos y cada uno de ustedes, a sus congresos, a sus países, a sus gobiernos. Dejo en ella la conducción de esta mesa y agradeciendo, por supuesto, a quienes integran este primer panel de esta tarde. Muchas gracias.
Thank you, Mr. President. As you heard, I am Mary King. I am a member of the Caribbean chapter of GOPAC and a member of the board, the secretary of the global board of GOPAC. I would like to begin by thanking the UNODC and the government of Panama for hosting this event. I think it's also in order to thank you, all of you, for participating in the fifth forum of parliamentarians. As a sign of GOPAC's ongoing commitment to this fight against corruption and to show its dedication to the UNCAC, the UNCAC, GOPAC is proud to be organizing this fifth forum of parliamentarians at the biannual conference of state parties to the UNCAC. To those of you who are already members of GOPAC, thank you for your continued efforts to reduce corruption both nationally, regionally, and of course, globally. For those who are less familiar with GOPAC, GOPAC has nearly 50 chapters worldwide. Each is non-partisan and formed by members of both houses of parliaments and all political parties, with a shared commitment to fighting corruption. We are now 11 years old, and our members have successfully introduced and passed legislation to improve their country's adherence to international anti-corruption standards. Through our global, regional, and national level chapters, our members support peers in other countries to attain their own anti-corruption goals and to overcome any obstacles that they should face. The Secretariat is based in Ottawa, and it also supports national chapters in a variety of ways. To address corruption issues, GOPAC divides its work into different thematic areas, such as the UNCAC, oversight of UNCAC implementation, society, participation of society, parliamentary oversight, parliamentary ethics and conduct, anti-money laundering, and of course recently we have just also developed a network for women. So members can join any of these task forces and partake in the work and the research that is done by GOPAC. Actually, the handbook that we're launching today, Improving Democratic Accountability Globally, which is a handbook for legislators on congressional oversight in presidential systems, was actually developed in response to members from congressional systems that felt that they didn't have a good understanding of the oversight tools available to them and that the existing capacity development material really focused on parliamentary systems and not on congressional or presidential systems. So in response to this request, GOPAC organized a study group in partnership with the World Bank Institute and hosted by the Office for Promotion of Parliamentary Democracy. This study group brought together legislators or former legislators from congressional systems with strong backgrounds in the oversight process of their own countries. In order to capture the knowledge gained at this study group, GOPAC and the World Bank Institute contracted two oversight experts, Dr. Rick Stapenshurst and Dr. Ricardo Paliso. They have subsequently produced two books that will soon be published by Routledge and two handbooks, the first one being the one and the feature of today's panel. So the goal of this particular panel is to focus on issues related to congressional oversight and present the key findings from that study group. It will introduce you to some of the main oversight issues and allow participants to discuss challenges of accountability, committee structures, and how parliamentarians from the different systems address the challenges of a strong executive. So this panel will begin the brief discussion on GOPAC's support to the UNCAC provided by this global task force, and it was actually chaired by, our global task force on that issue is actually chaired by Honorable Karamuddin Jafar. This will be followed by some insights into the challenges associated with oversight in presidential systems, and the second speaker will be our Honorable President of GOPAC, now President of GOPAC and former Senator in Mexico, Ricardo Garcia Cervantes. And our final speaker will be the Honorable Dr. Ricardo Paliso, Senior Consultant on Legislative Affairs at the World Bank and, of course, co-author of the handbook. So our first presenter, the Honorable Karamuddin Jafar, Chair of the Global Task Force for UNCAC. Honorable Jafar has held the Tumpat parliamentary seat since 1999 and served as Islamic Party of Malaysia General Secretary General from 2005 to 2009. He's been a member of the Public Accounts Committee since 2004. Prior to entering politics, he obtained degrees from the University of Kent at Canterbury and the School of Oriental and African Studies, University of London. So I hand you over to Honorable Jafar.
Thank you. Assalamu alaikum and a very good afternoon. Madam Chairperson, fellow panelists, fellow parliamentarians, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Global Organization of Parliamentarians Against Corruption, GOPAC, I would like to start by thanking UNODC for enabling GOPAC to once again hold the Forum of Parliamentarians alongside the Fifth Conference of States Parties to the United Nations Convention Against Corruption, UNCAC. This is the first Conference of States Parties, UNCAC, where GOPAC has been granted official observer status. Owing to the overwhelming support from the UNODC that we have received, we look forward to continuing our engagement with parliamentarians at future forums. I am honored to be here, as introduced by Mary King just now, for the first time in my new role as the chair of GOPAC's Global Task Force to the UNCAC. As most of us may be aware, my predecessor was Dr. Nasser Al-Sani, who has led this global task force with great passion and commitment. We all owe him a lot, and I have personally learned immensely from his leadership. I am equally honored to lead our other Global Task Force UNCAC members who are presently in the committee from Mali and Azerbaijan. And they have both shown leadership and commitment to this task force. As I am sure you are all aware, parliamentarians, as Mr. Chairman has just mentioned, parliamentarians play an important role in combating corruption and in ensuring that the legislation of their countries, of our countries, comply with international standards. In many of our countries, this means undertaking a process of legislative reform and coalition building among elected officials from different political persuasions in order to ensure domestic legislation facilitates the country's adherence to the UNCAC. This is why we have asked you, parliamentarians, who are our members and our greatest assets, to not only participate in this forum, but to engage in all aspects of our work with UNODC and the UNCAC coalition, which is having this conference here in Panama City this week. I ask that the work that is done here presently, the learning that is taking place, the network of peers that we have all been meeting from all over the world here in this week, the engagement with civil society, who are also participating in this GOSP UNCAC, that we bring all this back with us and we become leaders on the UNCAC in our countries. This convention has been ratified by 167 countries in the world, which is almost unanimous, though we have to admit there are one or two significant countries that have still not ratified it. Your governments have ratified it. We call, therefore, on you to ensure that having ratified the UNCAC Convention, that we, our countries, are going to seriously and effectively implement it. GOPEC's Global Task Force on UNCAC is prepared to support you. We can provide you with resources, information, and capacity building for national level workshops to build the momentum you need at a national level. So for all this assistance that you may require, please don't hesitate to contact, communicate to us. One new tool that would be of use is the anti-corruption tool for parliamentarians. This was created in partnership with the United Nations Development Programme, UNDP, to assist legislators in assessing their compliance with the UNCAC. It comprises a series of questions or checklists, answers to which serve to identify gaps in the effectiveness of a parliament's contribution to the implementation of the convention. By identifying the most serious gaps, plans can be put in place to strengthen a parliament's anti-corruption procedures with targeted improvements in legislation, in executive oversight, in budgetary control, and in the protection of standards of conduct in public life, as the case may require. I can report that four national chapters, Burkina Faso, Morocco, Timor-Leste, and Kyrgyzstan, have completed this exercise and found it very effective. I have been fortunate enough to participate in the ones in Timor-Leste and Kyrgyzstan. Each country came up with internal recommendations on how to progress with the implementation and enforcement of laws related to the UNCAC. For these countries, and for all our countries, a key role we play as legislators is to oversee the executive, the government, as it were, and hold them to account for their actions to ensure that policies are appropriately implemented and how they spend public funds. We are here at this panel today to discuss a specific type of oversight, which Madam Chairperson referred to, which is congressional oversight, which is very much relevant to this region. Though I and maybe Trinidad, we are Commonwealth, we are the Westminster system. Yeah. This is the congressional, in the terms of this booklet, presidential or semi-presidential system. This panel, therefore, is the official launch of this GOPAC World Bank Institute handbook to support legislators in their quest to maintain and improve oversight. I think, and I'm very sure, you will find the tool presented in the handbook to be helpful for improving oversight and a useful tool for curbing corruption. Thank you very much.
And thank you, Honorable Jaffar. Our second presenter and GOPAC chair was host of the global conference where our members from congressional systems actually raised this concern. He also was a member of the group and participated in the international study group. Mr. Ricardo Garcia Cervantes is a lawyer and the current chair of GOPAC. He has been a federal representative in three legislatures and a senator twice. In 2010, he was appointed chair of GOPAC Mexico and GOPAC Latin America. On 5th of December 2012, the President of the Republic of Mexico appointed him Deputy Attorney General for Human Rights, Crime Prevention, and Community Services of the Republic of Mexico. So over to Honorable Ricardo Cervantes.
Muchas gracias, Mary. Se ha dicho, y con razón, que esta es una reunión de líderes. No es casualidad. No es por accidente el que una persona se convierta en un representante de su comunidad y vaya a formar parte del poder legislativo, del parlamento en su país. Empiezo por reconocer su liderazgo, su autoridad. El hecho de que estén aquí, muchos de ustedes, hombre, es hasta evidente que estarían aquí. Son presidentes de capítulos de GOPAC en sus países. Son presidentes de los capítulos regionales, de la forma en la que estamos organizados. O forman parte de los grupos de tarea, los grupos de trabajo, en los que hemos dividido nuestra participación, nuestra acción en favor de la anticorrupción. Entonces, no solamente son líderes con una cualificación distinta. No quiero decir que esto es una pugna entre buenos y malos, no. Quiero simplemente reflejar que aquí hay parlamentarias, parlamentarios conscientes.